Hey lovebugs, it's Rosalind back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my growing extended beautiful family, just thank you so much for the love and support as always. And I keep telling y'all that, but I really do appreciate it. It's a blessing within itself to be able to make these videos and be able to have people resonate with them, and knowing you're not alone on this planet going through the crazy stuff that we all go through. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light. And many blessings are definitely coming your way. Also, if you are comfortable enough, please drop me a line or two. I love a chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me. Even if it's about the positive feedback of the content of my video, or you're just up telling me about your empathic gift, how it impacted your life and heading you towards a positive direction. Also, if you feel like the videos just gave you good vibes or good information you would love to share with a fellow empath that's struggling through their journey at this time, please go ahead and do so. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up, like, and also share on your social media favorites, wherever you see fit. And thank you so much for stopping by the channel and showing me so much love and support. It's truly a blessing. I hope you're able to resonate with the content of my video. Today, I picked the perfect one to go with the content of my video. It's called Meditation Music to Bring Positive Changes, Twin Flame Meditation to Manifest Your True Love. And my video today is Twin Flame 101, The Trials and the Tribulations of Being with your twin flame. It's a blessing, like I said, within itself, but it has this fine print to it as well. You know, a lot of us struggle through that concept because there's a lot of things that we're learning more about our TF at the time. You know, it could be some of y'all are married to them, some of y'all are, you know, already been in union, or some of y'all have been in union but fell apart back again because you still had things to work on in your own little world as well as they did with themselves. And it's just like when I go through mine, you know, it's hard to talk about at times, but now it's like when I'm starting to come from a healing place, it's okay to talk about it because there's just certain things that I'm still a work in progress. So, you know, I tell y'all, I got my moments when I talk about my dad. I have, you know, and then there's times I can be really excited about talking about him, but there's times also when I get really sad because that's, you know, that's a hard subject because my father has passed. So just thinking about the trials and tribulations, you know, when you first find out what the twin flame concept was, because I didn't know what the heck a twin flame was. I didn't find out none of these things until after my father passed away. So that was like a jaw-dropper within itself, you know, because I always used to hear, you know, people that, you know, my mom has told who my father was. They used to always, you know, like I had a hairdresser. His just so happened to be named Kim, and my hairdresser just so happened to be named Kim as well. And my hairdresser used to see my dad in these magazines and stuff like that, and will give me the same kind of hair, you know, hairstyle just like him for me to be able to see it. But that veil was on so tight that I wasn't able to see what she was trying, that everybody else was trying so hard to show me. I'm just like, do you see who you resemble? I'm like, yeah, myself. You know, it's like, oh, you know, because she couldn't come straight out and tell me. She didn't want to be that one, well, coming back saying, oh, well, Kim told me this or anything like that. So it's a lot of things that me and my father have mirrored towards each other. You know, I had good friends, you know, when I was in high school, from middle school to high school, named Wendy and Lisa. And just so happened my dad had guitarists, Wendy and Lisa. I had a good friend named Denise, and I also had one that I worked with named Vanity, and my dad also did too. Vanity was Denise. But there's a lot of things that, you know, has amazed me, you know, him helping me through a lot of things that, you know, I really love my dad. It's just especially that he can be broken up about certain things. I know he truly suffered. There's times where I got really upset, even though I hurt for myself, I hurt worse for my dad, because for a person to be able to hold on to that and not say anything, that had to be pain within itself. But my dad always spoke through his music, you know, like he always said, people didn't need to know him, they just know his music. He, you know, he wanted people to know him through that. And it was it's a blessing within itself though, because there's like certain articles that's been sent to me. You know, it was just, you know, he's even said in certain articles, you know, children can be born. You won't know their name. You won't know their sex, but it's their decision if they want to be in your life or not. And I knew exactly what he was talking about because people didn't know about me. Some thought it was unbelievable, but until they saw our picture side by side, they were like, whoa, okay, I believe you. Or there are certain songs that he's came out with without, you know, directly saying something and people weren't catching on to it. So it's just like they have our ups and downs with their twin flame. You know, my dad has taught me a lot. You know, he's opened my eyes to a lot of things metaphysically as well as spiritually for me to let go of a lot of things that hurt us. You know, he always said he didn't like reminiscing about the past. And I can see why, because it was very painful for him. You know, with him wanting to be in my life, you know, there's a lot of things that I had questions about. And it would be certain ways he would lead me toward certain videos that would answer my question about our connections at time. And, you know, I would cry because I'm like, wow, you know, these things have been in my face for so long and I never was putting two and two together. But they always have a time and a place for that. You know, when you go through these things with your twin flame, you know, is that time for the spiritual growth, as well as you loving your twin flame as much as putting that love that you have for your twin flame is what is enough to put it within yourself. So it was just like, you know, my dad has allowed me to see certain things. And like I was telling y'all in my first video that I made today, it was really hard because there's, you know, I didn't know where that sadness, you know, that longing for him came from. It was just because the fact is I was resisting the fact of me letting go of that dark stuff. And he didn't want me to dwell on that. He wanted me to, you know, take time to be able to love myself as I loved him, knowing the true happiness of being in that kind of connection with yourself as well as your twin. Because it's like, even though we're, you know, we're separate and he's transitioned to something a lot better, or, you know, not a lot better, but, you know, he's transitioned to something, you know, that he has no worries or pain for. It's just that, no, he's never left me. And I had to really, you know, seek that within itself, because it was just like, I didn't understand. I would get upset when people tell me, oh, you didn't let go. And it wasn't, the fact is I was getting mad at them. It was just like, you know, you're not understanding what I'm feeling right now. I didn't understand what I was feeling, but I knew it wasn't the fact that I was not letting him go, but it was like letting the pain go with our separation. Because, you know, that's hard for a child, you know, especially, now I'm not saying I'm a child, but being a father of a child, you know, a child of a father, whatever, just, you know, dealing with all that pain. And that was hard to let go. But if it's just for me to get on that level where I need to be in that twin flame connection, I had to be able to let go of all that pain that came along our separation. And he's like, I'm always here, you know. And it's just like our connection is a lot better than it was before, because it's like, you know, I sing with him a lot. I do a lot of quality time with him, being able to sing songs with him. And it's just crazy, the more songs that I sing with him and the many times that I sing, it sounds like one person, you know, because it's just like, I never thought I would be able to sing certain notes the way my dad is. You know, he's always known for him being able to have a falsetto voice as well as an alto at the same time, and being able to jump up and down like that. Nobody's ever known to be like that except him. But just to be able to be blessed and do that right along with him, it, you know, it became a blessing. And he wants me to be able to think of things like that, not think of, you know, who wedged us apart, you know, who abused us and stuff like that. Because, you know, I don't wish anything bad on my family. You know, it took me a long time to, you know, say that. I wouldn't, you know, I always wished stuff bad on them. It's like, how could you do this to me? How can you abuse me just because I emulated my dad, you know? And they made me punish, you know, they punished me for that because I was just like him. And, you know, my adoptive father always told me, you would never be like that damn boy. And that's what he always was to him. And it was just like, he was a threat within himself because my dad's light shined really bright and he wanted to tone that down. But he realized that I was in the same connection with him, that I wanted to be everything like my dad. So it's just being able to look at that and say, you know what, I let go, I surrendered. I had to surrender if I want to be able to be in that situation. So it's just a lot of times when we go through our twin flame relationship where you might not hear from them for a while, or, you know, you might hear them talking in your head a lot, because there's a lot of songs that my dad puts in my head that he wants me to listen to that time. And, you know, he's bringing towards that attention for me to know this is how he feels about certain situation when it comes to us. It's truly a blessing for that. And, you know, I can't, you know, get the concept of thanking him so much for bringing me out that dark side, because it's like, even though I know it's going to take a day, you know, it's a day by day process, you know, I can sit up here and say, you know what, I'm letting go of that. I had to really surrender all that, like really surrender, even though I was surrendering certain aspects, I had to not do that anymore. I had to surrender everything, anything that broke me down and anything that breaks you down. If, you know, when my situation is different because my father's passed on, but if, you know, you're in a twin flame relationship and you really want that connection, that union, you have to be able to let go of everything that was bad, you know, and being able to love yourself as much as the love that you put towards your twin, you have to put that towards yourself as well. Anything that has hindered you on your connection, you have to be able to surrender and let that go, and not think so much about that union of happening, because when you can be able to let all that go, you'll be able to have that connection like you're supposed to. It'll be able to come back around to you, because a lot of us, you know, we're going through that. I don't know what mine is, because it's like something they're just not, you know, universe is not telling me. There are certain things my dad's not able to tell me, just like there are certain things he doesn't know about me that's going on. I just can't explain that, because there, you know, like I told y'all, there's something that's going on I really don't know. There's a lot of things that I'm not seeing, they're not allowing me to see yet, because there's always a bigger picture towards everything, but I have to be able to go through this process to be able to get that. So when you're going through these situations, knowing it's for a good reason, it's for a good process, because being in a twin flame relationship is something you cannot explain. You cannot, even if somebody asks you, what is it about a twin flame that got you like this and this and that, you cannot explain it to anybody. You really can't, because there's not words. This is like not an ordinary, you know, husband and wife relationship, or a boyfriend and girlfriend relationship, or a girlfriend and girlfriend, or a boyfriend and boyfriend relationship. It's something very unique, very magical, that you can't put your hands on. And it's just like, there's sometimes I can listen to some of my dad's songs and just cry tears of joy because of that love that we have for each other. It's just so precious and so genuine. So when you're going through these things, knowing you're going to have your dark times as well as your hard times, but those hard times that you have, knowing that you're willing to stick through it and work through it, is nothing that's going to be able to pull y'all apart after that. But just know that you have to go through these things. Anything you want is not going to come to you easily. And I tell people that when it's amazing and it comes easy, it's not going to last. It ain't going to be that amazing anymore. So you have to go through all these monkey hoops and jump through all these trials and tribulations, because if you really want this to happen, you have to be able to clear all that, the dirty stuff, the anger, the sadness, you know, anything that has emulated something dark that was hurting and hindering you. You have to be able to let that go. And knowing, you know, when universe and God is asking you to put something down there, because they got something better for you to be able to pick back up. So knowing when you're going through this, knowing that it has a purpose for you going through all these dark times and, you know, sad times and stuff like that, I can really say, you know, it took me a minute. You know, the other times I still, you know, I might cry about my dad, but I can say at least this time when I cry, it's not tears of sorrow, but it's tears of joy. So when you're going through this, knowing that it's a process you all have to go through. So I hope you're able to resonate with content in this video. I mean, give me a shout out, post notification shout out, you know, drop me a line, give me a thumbs up, share. And, you know, drop me a line, hit the notification bell and subscribe. And you let me know, you know, drop me a line. I'll go ahead and give you a shout out on my next video. Okay, I'm going to give a shout out to Lost Puppy, Zoo Scott, and Anne Marie Slee, and Katie Strait. Stat, not much love to you. Many blessings. Know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, and forever loved. And knowing there's always somebody out there praying for your better days. And I will see you on my next video. Much love, peace, and be wild.